Didn't matter how you tried to get to work today from I-35.
Because I-35 southbound is shut down here from the Northland at Antioch.
To I-435.
There was a car in the center lane that, for some reason, started spinning out into the left lane and hit the car in front of me. And
to I-635, snowy roads made driving dangerous and turned rush hour into a crawl to work.
Good evening, everyone. We've had bigger snows this winter, leaving many drivers this morning wondering, what happened?
I think it surprised a lot of us. Why were the roads so bad in many spots? KMBC 9's Jerry Gish joins us live with some answers. Jerry?
Well, Larry and Kelly, everything is fine out here on 435. Tonight, traffic is moving along with no problem. That was certainly not the case, though, this morning. And really, it was a mix of events that led to all the problems. It's also a classic example that's not necessarily the amount of snow that you get.
Certainly was a tough morning for motorists.
The roads are still pretty slick, and there is a lot of snow covering out there.
And that meant accidents and fender benders all over the metro. The road crews were out plowing and putting down salt all night, so why weren't the roads better? Well, we start before the snow even came down. This storm started off as rain.
It makes it more difficult for us to pre-treat with salt, because if we pre-treat too early, that salt just washes away. It does no good at all.
Another factor, the roads weren't that cold when the snow started. In this case, that was actually a bad thing.
If we're in a situation where the pavements aren't cold when the storm starts, and if they're not, then as it gets colder, it bonds and it's hard for us to get off.
And that brings us to the third major factor. Temperatures dropped quickly and severely. Before road crews could prevent it, a hard snowpack formed.
If it lowers it so quickly that the salt no longer is effective, and it's also compromised by a lot of rain, it makes it much more difficult to get that stuff off.
Particularly when it's this cold and it really attaches itself to the open structure of the pavements, and we had to work extra hard to get it cleared.
So if you were wondering why a couple of inches of snow caused so many problems, the answer is rain and cold air.
It's not the amount of snow that comes down, it's how it comes down and how it's preceded.
And really, yesterday was a strange day. Even in the morning, there were cases of black ice up in the Northland, even though the temperatures were well above freezing. That certainly will not be the case tonight. The sun is down now, temperatures going down a little bit, and any roads that were wet out there during the day could be slick tonight. Reporting live in Kansas City, Jerry Gish, KMBC 9 News. Back to you.
Thank you, Jerry. Obviously some problems this morning, but the most serious crashes were actually last night. The snowy roads are blamed for 3 deaths in our area. This wreck near Platte City on southbound I-29 involved a car and a semi that overturned. The driver of the car, 18-year-old Kelsey Ryan of Platte City, died of her injuries. Ryan attended Park Hill South. Another deadly wreck was on U.S. 169 in Clinton County. 58-year-old Richard Turner of Trimble was killed when a truck slid head-on into his car. And in Ray County, 29-year-old Teresa Yautsey of Richmond died when her car skidded into the path of a semi on 10 Highway. And there were some injury accidents to report this morning. Johnny Rollins and News Chopper 9 took these pictures of a crash on I-635. This is just south of the Missouri River. And you can see crews removing one person on a backboard. No word yet on just how serious those injuries were. Larry?
Kelly, in addition to the serious accidents, there were dozens of fender benders and cars in the ditches. Even the people trying to clear the accidents sometimes ran into trouble this morning. Check this out. A tow truck driver slid off the exit ramp to 119th from I-35. Driver George Rocha, he had to call in another tow truck to get him out.
I was headed to a police accident, I-35 northbound there, and was trying to get around traffic and slid right off into the ditch. So it happens.
Rocha says he wanted to get his truck out fast because he knew he was in for a lot of business with all the people sliding off the roads. In many spots around town, cars simply couldn't make it past the slick spots. That's where good Samaritans like these on Blue Ridge Boulevard made all the difference, providing a push to get drivers back on their way. So how do you size up the condition of roads this morning? Our online poll wants to know, do you think road crews were prepared for this latest round of snow? Go to KMBC.com and look under news links.